Good morning, everyone.
Morning,
and welcome along here to St. Teresa's Church in Newarthill for the Requiem Mass for Ellis Clapperton. We come to the church with Ellis's mum and dad, Martina and Alan, his family, including his aunts and uncles and cousins, his friends, including those from Taylor High School, neighbours, and all other people who knew Ellis too. And we also welcome on our live stream all those who are not able to be here with us in the church, especially his gran in Ireland, family and friends of the family, and members of the current second year in Taylor, and their teachers, as well as others who knew Ellis too. We come here today during this Mass to pray for Ellis. He's now in heaven. We also pray for everyone affected by the passing of Ellis. Once again, I offer my sincere sympathy to Martina and Alan, to all the family, to everyone who knew Ellis. As I said yesterday in the assembly at Taylor for the second years, this is a time of real sadness. A son, a grandson, a nephew, a cousin, friend has been taken away from us so young. But at the same time, the Catholic faith tells us that Ellis will be in heaven and receiving eternal life, that each one of us who believes in Jesus will receive, because Jesus promised us that. Again, we all have varied and different experiences of Ellis, a loved son, a cherished grandson, a special friend, to name a few. Ellis lived here on earth until he was 13, and during all those years, he showed how unique and special he was. As Martina and Alan later share with us some of what was Ellis, their much-loved son, who gave them so much and love, who gave them so much love and life, albeit, as they say, he was only with us for a short while. As we continue our Requiem Mass for Ellis, and as we do at the beginning of every Mass, we acknowledge that we are here in the presence of God, and we acknowledge our sins, and so prepare to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you came to show us the love and mercy of the Father. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant Ellis, who has now fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. And now we sit down for our readings with Mohammed and Matthew coming forward.
First reading, a reading from the book of Isaiah. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will prepare for all peoples a banquet of rich food. On this mountain, he will remove the mourning veil covering all peoples, and the shroud enwrapping all nations. He will destroy death forever. The Lord will wipe away the tears from every cheek. He will take away his people's shame everywhere on earth, for the Lord has said so. On that day, it will be said, "See, our God, this is our God in whom we hoped for salvation. The Lord is the one in whom we hoped. We exult and we rejoice that he has saved us." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Say to the Lord, my refuge,
Second reading, a reading from the first letter of Paul to the Theolossians. We want you to be quite certain, brothers, about those who have died, to make sure that you do not grieve about them, like the other people who have no hope. We believe that Jesus died and rose again, and that it will be the same for those who have died in Jesus. God will bring them with him. With such thoughts as these, you should comfort one another. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to the crowd, "All that the Father gives me will come to me, and whoever comes to me, I shall not turn him away, because I have come from heaven, not to do my own will, but to do the will of the one who sent me. Now the will of him who sent me is that I should lose nothing of all he has given to me, and that I shall raise it up on the last day. Yes, it is my Father's will that whoever sees the Son and believes in him shall have eternal life, and that I shall raise him up on the last day." The Gospel of the Lord. Would you like to have a seat again, please? Our readings tell us of eternal life, a life of a prepared banquet of rich food for all peoples who have been saved by Jesus Christ. Indeed, we read that we exult and we rejoice that he has saved us. The second reading reminds us that through Jesus we have hope, a hope that for those who have died in Jesus, God will bring them with him. With such thoughts as these, we should comfort one another. Again, the gospel I read reassures us that each one of us is so special to Jesus, and as was the will of God the Father, that whoever sees the Son and believes in him shall have eternal life, and that I shall raise him up on the last day. Ellis, I believe, is now having a share in that eternal life, a life with Jesus, who loved him on earth and is now loving him and taking care of him in heaven. In all, it is with these thoughts that we take part in this Mass today. The love that Ellis gave and will continue to give, albeit in a changed way, is a sign of God the Father's, Jesus's, and the Holy Spirit's love and care for each one of us. A love and care that helps us cope now and in the future. And a reality that, as we will pray later in the Mass, we will all meet Ellis again. I'll now read from the information that Martina and Alan prepared for today. Our dear Ellis was born on Saturday, the 3rd of July, 2010, at 1:23 a.m., weighing 9 pounds and 13 ounces, in Wishaw General Hospital, to his parents, Martina and Alan. He had a lovely, smiling face and was so content, he didn't really ever cry. He took his first steps a year later and continued to grow into such a great wee boy. Ellis's preschool years were spent with mum and dad, and when they were working, he was with caring childminders. One was with a group of other boys. They were fondly referred to as the playful lion cubs. Ellis was the younger of that set of cubs, so he had to stand his ground when needed and wasn't shy in telling the others when they were wrong. He then moved to Our Lady in St. Francis Primary School in Kirfin. He enjoyed primary school, and in the early years, he was not afraid of the microphone and gave one wonderful rendition of Let It Go. He also went to an out-of-school club and took delight in wearing a bear costume for a while. It was there that he learned to ride a bike. After primary 7, he moved to Taylor High School, which only seems was for a brief time. But he enjoyed his time there and was doing well. He enjoyed his classes and playing football on a Friday afternoon. Over the past few months, he missed a lot of school. When he was there, he continued to sit tests and sat one just before the February break. Although he did enjoy the occasional nap in English, but that was only in the last month. Ellis was a lovely wee boy who loved gaming on his PlayStation, playing football and seeing his friends, cousins, and the rest of the family in Scotland and Ireland. He spent many a happy holiday over in Ireland, seeing his gran and the open spaces there. He also enjoyed getting to mind his grandpa, and they had a lovely wee bond. Ellis enjoyed time with his dog called Buddy, and managed to get one final walk with him only a couple of weeks ago when visiting family in Ayr, who Buddy is holidaying with. Ellis was a very smart and inquisitive boy. As a baby, he did not like lying in his pram and wanted to be able to see what was going on. On early family holidays, the buggy was exchanged for his dad's shoulders so he could see the world. When he touched the ground, he soon made a break, including one escape under the barriers in the Barcelona metro. Luckily, a woman managed to hold him up. His inquisitive nature did have its drawbacks. He wanted to know what would happen if you tickled a bee's behind. And unfortunately, he soon found out. This was one of Ellis's traits. He needed to know and find out for himself. This was just a sore one. He enjoyed spending time with a great group of friends who, over the last few months, although they may not be aware of it, gave Ellis an amazing amount of support and such a lift. Continuing to be a teenager, go to school, and what was his friends to school was very important with Ellis. I hope his friends continue recreating memorable football moments and remember the impact they had in making Ellis happy. Ellis was well aware of what was going on and had a cracking sense of humour, but he could also be serious and focused when required. Ellis was a kind and caring boy who knew when to give his mum a wee hug and be there for others. Ellis was more than the last 10 months, but this period highlighted what a remarkable and brave young man he was. Since last April, Ellis has had two surgeries, one in Portugal, the other in Glasgow. Nearly 7 weeks of radiotherapy in Manchester, multiple procedures, and heard bad news. Bad news that for a 13-year-old, it's difficult to imagine how he coped with it all in such a calm way. However, over this time, Ellis was determined to lead a normal life, and we are in awe of how he managed to do this. He was adamant about going back to school and was still preparing for a future and had picked his subjects for third year and had mentioned about wanting to go to Mexico for a summer holiday. Ellis has had to spend a lot of time with his mum and dad, which for a young teenager really cramped his style. However, he did enjoy sitting down to watch TV and movies as a family, especially if a pizza was included. We are extremely proud of Ellis. He never complained, and the response to "How are you?" was always "I'm fine," even when it was clear he wasn't. As long as there was good Wi-Fi, he was happy. Ellis sadly left us on Wednesday, the 21st of February, and though Ellis was only with us for a short time, he will never be forgotten and will be in our hearts and be loved forever. We carry him in our hearts and thoughts, so he is never really gone. Ellis, our son, grandson, nephew, cousin, and friend. For Ellis, we all say together, eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him, and may he rest in peace. Amen.
And now we stand for our bidding prayers, and Nathan, Lennon, and Cyrus are going to come and read those for us.
For Ellis, that God has taken him to his home in heaven, and that he has been held in God's loving care now and forever. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For all those affected by the death of Ellis, especially his mum Martina, dad Alan, all his family, friends and all those who knew him, that may they know the healing power of Jesus, both now and in the future. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For all who experience ill health, that they may always receive the care they need and be helped to cope with their situation. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For those who look after people with ill health, we thank them for all they do and ask that they will always feel supported and cared for. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Just in a few moments, in our own hearts, if we have any prayers of our own, we make them just now. Lord, hear us. And we ask the intercession of our Blessed Lady, the Mother of Jesus, as we say together, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Heavenly Father, we ask you to hear all these prayers that we've made, including any in the silence of our own hearts, and we ask you to grant them through Christ our Lord. Now we're going to sit down for our offertory hymn and our procession. Gifts there in the offertory procession of the water and wine and the bread for the communion. Some of Daniel Ellis's friends, Daniel, brought up a wee sheet there with some stories about Ellis and just given that to Martina and Alan. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Please stand. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for your servant Ellis, we ask you to continue to show him your mercy and love, and that you will continue to show him that you are a loving Saviour who lives and reigns forever and ever. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as one alone he accepted death so that we might all escape from dying. As one man he chose to die so that in your sight we might all live forever. And so in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you and with joy we proclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you've created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven. And as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Teresa and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Joseph, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Ellis, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he, who was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages and praise you without end, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow in the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours forever and ever. Can I ask you to stand again, please? At the Saviour's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Of the
Please kneel or sit. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let perpetual light shine upon him with your saints forever, for you are merciful. In a few moments, myself and Jerry will come forward and offer Holy Communion. If for any reason you're not able to receive Holy Communion, but you would like a blessing, then just come to myself and put your hands across your chest like so.
Thank you.
Please stand. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant, strengthened by it, our brother Ellis may come and be at the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. And now we come to our final commendation here in the church.
See you. come to his aid. Come to meet him, angels of the Lord. Receive his soul.
Ellis to his place of rest. May the angels lead you to paradise. May the